football, but we just didn't think they were going to be able to throw it over the top of us. And so we were disappointed in our secondary play in the first half, obviously.
But there was no disappointment for the Tigers secondary in the second half. Several spectacular plays, the biggest one coming with 5 seconds left in regulation. Senior Eric Nitsch picks off the Oak Creek pass, and the Tigers are state champions for the first time.
Complete elation. I couldn't describe it any other way. I've dreamed of this all my life, and now we've got it.
We just had to go nuts. That's our D-line motto is, have you gone nuts today? And we did it in the second half.
It's amazing. The team, everyone's all together. It's just great. It's just everyone loves each other right now, and we're state champs.
Indeed, and again, congratulations to the Tigers. Way to go, guys. Okay, now they've talked the talk. Now it's time to walk the walk. Packers and Cowboys, Lambeau Field. Noon tomorrow, what more can be said? Rising up, straight to the top. Have the guts, got the glory.
Went the distance, now I'm not gonna stop. Just a man and his will to survive. It's deep, eye of the tiger, it's the thrill of the fight. Rising up to the challenge of our rival.
I play this character called Mr. Pete.
Marshfield Tiger football team, after huddling on the field, now going back to the sideline, saluted by the Tiger fans, many of whom have made the trip down to Madison tonight to watch this ball game this afternoon and this evening. Marshfield Senior High wins the WIAA Division I state championship, defeating Oak Creek 21-14. Boy, once again, Dale, what excitement we had out here today.
Well, it's only fitting that it had to come down to one last play, didn't it, Gene? Just the way the season went, and the Tigers came up with a big play again at the end to preserve the win. And Marshfield Orange up and down that sidelines over there right now at the railing. Tigers waiting their turn to come out and accept their individual medals for their letter jackets and also the championship trophy.
The state runner-up trophy will be presented to the Oak Creek Ball Club and Coach Joe Cook. You may recall that about 7 years ago, Coach Cook was on this field winning the WISA Division II state championship as head football coach at Whitefish Bay Dominican, defeating the Columbus Dons, coached by Walt Kroll. Now, 7 years later, the Marshfield Tigers turn the tables on Coach Cook, and they defeat him to win the Division I WIAA state championship. Boy, what a ball game we had this evening as night begins to fall here in southern Wisconsin. And the Marshfield Tigers win the Division I state championship, a 21-14 winner. We were talking all through this ball game, Dale, about how great the offenses were, how they ran up and down the field today, but once we got past that first quarter, we only had one score.
Well, again, you know, it takes a while for these teams who haven't seen each other, and all they've seen is a little bit of tape. They haven't had much time to prepare, so it comes down to those one-on-one battles out there between these young men at each and every individual position. And once they become a little bit more accustomed to each other's moves in that offensive line here, sometimes you'll see that where a game settles down a little bit. And Oak Creek at time looked like they were going to gain the upper hand as far as field position. It didn't look like Marshfield was going to be able to stop them, and then they'd be able to come up with a key play and put the stops on. And so, you know, Marshfield Tigers, 1997 state champions. Who'd have thunk it, to a certain extent, Gene, not selling the program.
And now the state championship trophy will be presented to the Tigers.
You hear the fans now. Marshfield band playing Eye of the Tiger during that last timeout that we had.
Shannon Nicolay and Chris Fergie. Brad Lenz, Brad Varsho, Nick German out to accept the trophy. Now here comes Coach Lipke out. And Coach Lipke raising that championship trophy, receiving the cheers from the Marshfield fans. Marshfield Tigers, WIAA Division I state football champions for 1997. Again, our final score in this championship game this afternoon, Marshfield 21 and Oak Creek 14. We'll come back to check the scoring plays in today's contest right after these messages.
Good evening. Welcome to Marshfield Senior High, and how about one quick one for the champions? One quick announcement. Deer hunting's been put off for 3 days. No, not really. Congratulations to the Marshfield Tigers, Division I state champions in football. Let's get Len Lutke up here right now. Lenny?
Thank you very much for the tremendous welcome back. It's been a real journey for us this season, and today was as good a finish as it could have happened. It came down to the final end again, and some things just happen to good people, and this is a great group of athletes, and give those guys another round of applause, please. What I'd like to do right now is I'd like to introduce my assistant coaches and put them on the spot a little bit. Usually you just hear the things that I have to say, and I know some of those guys got an awful lot of words of wisdom, and I'm going to put them on the spot, and then we'll get a chance to get to our seniors and some of our other athletes. So I'd like to introduce them. First of all, our offensive coordinator, Denny Gadel.
First of all, I'd like to say a big thank you again to Coach Len Lutke for giving me the opportunity to do what I get to do here. It's been just a tremendous experience for me working with these young men. And I'd like to say sorry to all you folks for all the coronary and, you know, things like that, heart attack arrests and all that we've caused you in the last 3 weeks. Again, thanks to our senior crew and all the young men that are coming up. And thank you for all the support you've given us, especially you senior parents and all the parents that have been kind of cooking for us every Thursday night. I know my wife's happy that she doesn't have to cook on Thursday nights anymore, so it's been great. Thanks a lot.
Next, I'd like to introduce our secondary coach and special teams coach, Jerry Littman.
I'd also like to thank every one of you that have supported the team throughout the year. This is not just a win for Marshfield High School, but it's a win for the entire community. We appreciate the support that you have given us throughout this fantastic, unforgettable season. I, like the rest of the coaches, don't know how we survived this season without coming down with some kind of ailment to the heart or the brain or something. But this is for the entire community, the school, everybody. Statewide, who has given this team support. I'd just like to thank everybody from the bottom of our hearts. And like Coach Lutke said, good things happen to good people, and this is one class of individuals here. Thanks again.
I'd like to introduce now our running back coach, the only guy that can go out there bare-legged for no matter what temperature it is, Lee Weigel.
This is something that's unbelievable. What a rush, guys, what a rush. It's been a thrill watching these young men come together and mature over the year. At first, we weren't real sure how we'd come together, but you know, in the off season, they worked their butts off, their tails. I mean, this season wasn't won in the tournament time here, but it was won in the off season. It's a great tribute to these young men, the rest of the coaching staff that pushed them all along. I mean, we're one tight family. as a coaching staff, as players. We just kind of all meshed real well this year. So let's do it next year again. Let's repeat. Thank you.
I thought Pete Kiplin put pressure on us last spring.
Holy man.
Our offensive line coach this year, we brought up a new man to give us a chance, so I didn't have to coach the offense anymore. And Ron did a great job for us coaching our offensive line, Ron Staromski.
Thank you. Not too many people know this, but Coach Weigel and I are twin brothers. As Coach Lukey said earlier, we do have some great athletes on this team, especially in the skill position. But there are a group of people over here that you don't see their name in the paper very often, and you really don't hear much about them. In fact, I believe Coach Gale refers to them as pigs. And I am talking about the offensive and defensive linemen. I'd like to give them a nice hand right at this time. Thank you.
Next coach, but not least, we've got three very excellent coaches that have worked with our sophomore group and made that program, or that team was an undefeated team this year, 9-0, and I want to give those three gentlemen also a chance to address this group. First of all, Mr. Recruiter for the Marshfield football team, Mr. Promoter, whatever we need done, when we need something done, has just done a great job for the, you know, for the entire program and the success we've enjoyed, Mr. Jim McDonald.
Thank you very much, Len. I'd like to say thanks to all our fans, and I tell my defensive linemen that good things happen to good people, and I really believe that. And to my right, we have 70 fine young men. Thank you.
Our next coach probably has the toughest task of all, and that's listening to Coach Gadel on the headset from up above and trying to keep things in control. This gentleman has done a great job for us in putting our offense together and helping us to get things done offensively. Our sophomore coach coaches our receivers, Paul Fagan.
I think he's right. He said I had the toughest job. Keeping Coach Gadel down is pretty tough sometimes. I had a special opportunity here to coach these seniors in seventh grade football, sophomore football, and now help on the varsity level. And I don't think you'll find a better group of young men, and I think it's a real tribute to this group of seniors and every one of these guys over here. Great job.
And last but not least, we've got three Marshfield alums that are coaching with us, Lee Weigel, Jim McDonald, and our last coach helps our special teams work with our receivers as well, Coach Scott Klein.
Thank you very much. Yes, I do need a stool here. I usually get picked on by the players, but I tell you what, if we go to state every year, I'll take all the razzing from these guys that they can dish out. I just want to add one thing. It is neat to see what's happened with the community. I think I'm the only one on the staff that teaches in elementary schools,
And the Tiger pride has trickled down into the elementary schools, and it's kind of neat to see those young kids getting involved. They are going to be the future of Marshfield football, but I think these young gentlemen over here have been the trendsetters. People have come up to the coaches and said, great job. We can't do it without those guys right there.
The voting has not yet taken place on a lot of things from the football season, but why don't we take a straw vote of applause for maybe the coach of the year in football in the state of Wisconsin? And while we're at it, how about for the staff of the year, right over there? Now, you can never get this many people together in one place and have a politician pass up the opportunity. Mayor Richard Daniels.
I was driving by the theater, and on the marquee at Rogers Cinema, it said Lutke for president. And I says to myself, thank God it wasn't Lutke for mayor. I'm in big trouble. We're very proud of what you accomplished today. You made history in Marshfield in terms of going to state, but most important in terms of bringing home that trophy. That's very impressive. Isn't it a lot more fun to make history than to study it? No, I think our Tigers are fired up enough. Maybe we should send them to Lambeau Field on Sunday and knock off those Dallas Cowboys. You can handle that, right, Coach? No, we are truly proud of you as we in office try to promote the city and put our best foot forward. It's nice to have the help of your team and the job that you've done to put Marshfield on the map. And I've got to give credit to you, Coach, and the building that you have accomplished over the years. And I can see a lot of good things to come in the future. This is just the beginning. And thanks again. You've done a great job for the city.
Ah, yes, the man who puts everyone under pressure. Let's welcome Athletic Director Pete Kaplan. Pete.
Sorry I'm late. I stopped to eat. I wanted to get the food before Nick Volochek did. He hasn't eaten for a while. He's probably lost about 40 pounds already. Seriously, I stopped at the WIAA office at Camp Randall, and they told us, they took a little straw count, we out pre-sold the next school by 600 pre-sales. That was Menominee, and we had 1,800 pre-sales. Oak Creek had 900. They estimated that Marshfield had between 4,000 and 5,000 people there at night. By far the biggest crowd of any school at the state tournament, and it shows you what good fans we have, and I think the football players give all our fans one more big hand. I only did two things to help this happen. One of them was I matched the prophet Isaiah last spring when we won the state softball tournament. And at the welcome home party like this, I said, the next state tournament we win will be in football. And I was right. C, seems like Coach Littke does real well under pressure, so I'm going to predict that we're going to do it again next year and the year after. Finally, the last thing I did, the only other thing I did that was had any part of this great state championship was 3 years ago when Mr. Myers and I hired Coach Littke. The community is great. The fan support was great. Coaching staff is the best in the world, but it goes right down to the bottom line is we have the best football team in the state of Wisconsin. Thank you very much.
Well, Lenny, after fourth and 15, at the Rapids game and you come through there, how could you not win the next two state championships, right?
Yeah.
Marshall, will you get a haircut? All right, let's bring Len Lutke back up here, all right?
One thing that has been a major factor in the success that we've enjoyed is the increased participation. We really went out to recruit athletes to get involved in the football program, and as you can see, you know, we suited up 71 people today, and you know, there's 36 seniors on this squad, and we started 18 seniors, 9 on offense and 9 on defense today, and you know, you win with seniors, especially in football. Nothing wrong with sophomores, but the only good thing about a sophomore is someday there'll be a senior. And I want to give a chance to 4 of these young men to come up and talk to you. We're not going to give everybody a chance to do that, but I don't pick captains in the spring, and you know, we don't do some of those things. We kind of look for kids that are young men that are going to take the leadership role and not necessarily be picked in the leadership role. And I think the 4 young men that are going to get a chance to talk to you this evening did just that. They're not necessarily some of the kids that you would necessarily expect to take a leadership role on a football team, but all 4 of these young men definitely made the difference in putting this team together. And I'm not going to bring them up in any particular order, but we'll start out with, as far as I'm concerned, one of the toughest little linebackers, nose guards in the state of Wisconsin, Brad Lenz.
First thing I'd like to say, and I speak on behalf of the team, is that we love our new shoes. The biggest thing that helped us out to this season, though, is our crazy fans up here. All our fans, the fan support. Another thing that helped us out, too, through the season is the fact that our coaches are such family-oriented guys, and they brought us all together as a team. And I'm really going to miss everyone after this season's over, because this is our last time together now. And I just want all the seniors to enjoy this and live it up tonight. So thanks a lot, everybody.
And the next captain we're going to give a chance to talk to you turned into one of our most physical ball players. Just an outstanding job in the weight room. Came through a knee surgery almost a year ago. Came back to become one of the best offensive linemen, Chris Fergie.
Thank you.
I'd like to also thank the seniors that put the time in the weight room this year. It was great going in every time to see those guys working hard, and we really built a dream. And no one else believed but us, and we came through, and it's been the greatest thing that's ever happened in my life. I'd also like to thank Coach Mack and all the guys that picked rock this summer to get the new weight machines. Because I think they really did make the difference in Marshfield football rules!
Our third captain, I think, really did the most outstanding job in bringing this team together, and we were looking for a person like this. We don't know who it's going to be, and you know, it's up in the air every year as far as who's going to take charge. And this young man did a super job for us. Had a great game today down on Madison. Nick German.
I love you guys. You guys are the greatest people in the world. You guys are the best. And the people that I'd really like to thank the most is our parents for putting up with us after practice when we have our little aches and pains and everything like that. And definitely for the meals you guys put on every Thursday night. They're the best. We love you guys.
And last but not least, every good offense needs a trigger man. And we've got a great quarterback. He's had some exceptional games, some exciting finishes for us in the last few weeks. But today we finally found out what he could really do, and that's run the football, Brad Varsho.
Hi, guys. I just want to thank mainly the fans. They've been great all year, and Coach Gato for putting up with a lot of crap that I pulled. And you know, me and Coach Gato, we had our differences at times, but he always, you know, straightened me out and helped me when I needed it. The offensive line, they did a great job this year. And what's that lens? Oh, okay. The offensive line did great this year. It was amazing. You know, they came together, and we had two sophomores come up for us, and they did a great job. I'd also like to thank the rest of the coaching staff. I mean, it was a big family for us. They did a great job, and you know, it's just amazing what they can do and what they all do for us. Thank you.
Gonna hear for a minute from Dennis Myers. Denny.
I want to thank the WIAA, first of all, for having the expanded playoffs. Realize that under the old system, this team would have never been in the playoffs. So that expanded playoffs gave kids like this a chance to do what they've done. And I think that's a great thing for high school football in Wisconsin. Secondly, as I looked over the fans in Camp Randall today, I saw all those alumni football players from years and years back. And for those of you who are not aware of the history of Marshfield football, it isn't real glorious. 1932 was the last time we won a conference title. In the late 1960s, we went through a period where we suffered about 30 losses in a row. I happened to come in the fall of 1969 and was a football coach, and we won the first game to break that streak, the fourth game of the season, and we were carried off the field because it was the greatest thing that had happened to Marshfield football. And one can only realize how far we've come if you've suffered through those dark days of Marshfield football. And I am so proud of this group, and proud doesn't seem to be a word that really captures the moment. There needs to be something else, but that's the best we have right now. I want to thank all the faculty people who chaperoned, We have championship fans, and you need championship fans to have a championship team. I was so proud of our kids today in the stands and on the field. There's not a greater feeling that I could have at this moment than to be the principal of a high school that just won the state championship.
A year ago on this day, I stood in a store in Wausau with a businessman up there who happens to be a big backer of the Everest Evergreens. They were in the process of losing a very close game in the state title game to Arrowhead. And he turned to me and he said, you know, the Marshfield program really seems to be coming on. When do you think they're going to be on that turf? Not to be a man to be pinned down, I just said soon. Lenny, sooner the better. Thank you. Come on up.
When you get to the end of the season, and you know we hoped it would never come to an end, but it's going to be a tough time, you know, for all of us and all of you as well that have shared in this journey with us. And we talk to the team, we're never ever going to get together like we were together today, and all they can do now is put these moments deep inside them, and you know the film will be there and some of the other things will be there, but it'll never ever be the same, you know. And these guys that are seniors, that are gone, or that will be graduating, we're never going to get the same feeling that we have and we share right now. And you know, I hope for you guys seniors that that this is what it was all about. You know, we talked a long time ago when you guys were sophomores, you know, the little algebra equation that we hopefully tried to instill in them, and the idea that a goal plus a plan plus work equals reality, and a goal plus no plan plus no work equals a dream. And we ended every game with the same kind of a chant. Well, there were a couple times we didn't, I guess, but the majority of them we ended with the same chant, and we did it again today at Camp Randall. And this is the best one of all, guys. This is the one, the state champion one. All right, here we go. Sometimes I'm not sure they're always listening to me. But at the end of each contest, we came up with usually a few one-liners, and then we ended up with, reality is!
Is Dennis Kramer here somewhere? Dennis Kramer, is he here somewhere? Well, we want to report a major accomplishment for the band today. They did not leave at halftime. All right. Really, though, and seriously, Dennis Kramer helped put this thing together. Those were all of his fireworks out there. He's probably out sweeping up the cinders right now. I don't know, but congratulations to Denny. And how about all of you people giving yourselves a hand for backing this team all year long? That's going to wrap things for tonight. Thank you for coming. Drive home safely, celebrate safely, and one more big round of applause for the Division I state champs, the Marshfield Tigers.